We believe in cherishing dreams, in sharing our success. We believe in not just building industries, but individuals as well. Corporate social responsibility is more than just a word at the Jindal Group. It's a commitment.
No effort, be it industrial or otherwise, is sustainable unless it takes the needs of society into consideration. We cherish people. Our area of focus are education, livelihood and empowerment, health, sports, conservation and environment.
An innovative and visionary approach to learning. The motive is to get students excited about learning by teaching them through creative, innovative methods and also retain them in schools. We have introduced 71 interactive subject series in 3 languages and trained local teachers to improve the quality of education. Parents too are excited as they see hope in education. What happens to children who have to grow up too soon? Whose aspirations remain hidden within shadowy cobwebs of the mind? What happens to children who learn harsh reality before they learn to dream?
Anganwadi provides children with a wholesome meal. We at JSW try to go a step forward by providing them with low-cost kits and a training in early child education. The basic aim behind this was to empower the children right from their childhood.
ही खेळातून शिक्षण ही ज्यावेळेला आम्हाला किट त्यांनी दिली तर ती खरोखर उपयुक्त अशी ठरली. आणि त्यावेळेला आमची मुलं पण म्हणजे अगदी उत्साहित झाली.
The project Village Learning Centers has been set up to teach rural children who, owing to poverty, are deprived of education. So far, 72 students have been mainstreamed.
Adolescence is a stormy phase of one's life. Children are going through a transition during this phase. They are passing from childhood into an adulthood. And this phase is characterized by a lot of confusion that children have. And if you do not provide them information at this stage, it would lead to a lot of perversion. The life education program basically aims at easing this stress and helping them to understand this transitory phase and pass through it very smoothly.
The uniqueness is the visionary approach taken to learning. Teaching methods are interactive and experiential, keeping textbook learning to the minimum. Audio-visual aids, diverse projects, and a host of extracurricular activities keep the students active and intelligent as the learning goes beyond mugging. Another day dawns on the horizon of man's hope, and smiles come forth even in dark despair as the hand of concern reaches out with a firm grip. The foundation conducts regular health camps at least twice a month. Free eye camps are also conducted.
अभी हमारे ये प्रोजेक्ट जब से शुरू हुआ है मई 2005 से तो लोगों ने बहुत इंटरेस्ट इसमें दिखाया है को उनके हेल्थ एलिमेंट को प्राइमरी स्टेज पे डिटेक्ट करके डायग्नोस करते हैं और अकॉर्डिंगली ट्रीटमेंट देते हैं.
Taking funding one step beyond money, we have provided land and hygienic cooking conditions. We also focus on nutrition development amidst children by providing wholesome meals and vitamins. The project took off in June 2006, feeding 3,500 children.
I find that this hospital provides a very unique way of treating patients because it cares for the underprivileged. It's not here just merely to make money or profit. The people are employed here so that they can take care of the community. We run a 24-hour OPD. We have a very well-equipped operating theatre, intensive care unit, and we specially ordered and designed and had an ambulance constructed for us which has a ventilator that can run for 12 hours on an ambulance battery.
In our souls, there is a song to be free, to rise above our circumstances. Who will hear our muffled cries and take us to the realization of our dreams?
मैं यहाँ काम करते हुए एक साल हो गया. मैं तो यहाँ सोची थी नहीं कि यहाँ आऊँगी और ये काम करूँगी बोल के. यहाँ तो बहुत अच्छा लगता है. संगीता मैडम ने है सब लड़कियों के लिए बहुत अच्छा किया.
We have covered around 28 villages and radius of 60 kilometers. Now, currently there are around 300 women who work in 24/7, and people start flowing in. Then we train them for 3 to 6 months on keyboard skills. After training, we put them on the project train. Our efforts is to change rural India into urban India.
They live in tune with nature. They form 70% of our human capital. We believe the soul of our country needs to be emancipated. The Mahila Dairy Development Group aims at creating livelihood opportunities for rural villagers without removing them from their setting. Fodder production workshops and free veterinary checkups are also conducted. Self-help groups are also being started, which help the women to form a society and start entrepreneurial businesses. Vocational training is an important facet of livelihood generation, as not everyone can afford or is interested in education. Here, adolescents are trained in various activities to provide them with skills to make a decent living. Yet another stroke of genius. Who could have thought that women could do that? But right here in the JSW plant, that's exactly what is happening. The women took it up as a challenge and with training have proven the metal within them. It makes us proud that women in our plant stand on equal ground as men.
ಆದರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಶ್ವಿನಿ ಗುಪ್ತಾ ಸರ್ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಧೈರ್ಯ ತುಂಬಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರೇರೇಪಿಸಿದ್ರು. ನಾವು ಇವಾಗ ತುಂಬ ಧೈರ್ಯದಿಂದ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗಿ ಬದುಕಬಲ್ವಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಂದು ಆತ್ಮವಿಶ್ವಾಸ ಕೂಡ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂಡಿದೆ.
Realizing the importance of crop productivity, we are developing 3 seed villages. The idea is to create crop diversification by providing high quality seeds of various crops to farmers. We also provide biofertilizers and conduct capacity building activities.
We build industries, but we respect and conserve nature. Ours is the only zero effluent discharge plant in the world.
Currently, we are running a 4 million ton plant. Generally, 1 ton of steel requires 3,300 liters of water, and we can proudly say that no water goes waste.
This is the place where we receive treated water from all the steel works. This is pumped back to different units in the steel plant for different applications. Thus, by using of water by cascading in different units, we are able to conserve maximum amount of water. We at JSW have spent enormous amount of money in conserving water, be it in terms of water treatment or in case of water wastewater usage. This is how we are making the water consumption least so that all other people who are deprived of water can be benefited.
Striving towards excellence has always been our motto. To further excel in sports, we have set up sports academies at both Vasind and Vijayanagar.
Jindal Squash Academy has produced nearly about 35 national players and 2 world-class, 7 international squash players. Now this year we have got 1 boy and 1 girl who is representing India in 2008 at Switzerland. All the credit goes to JSW, who has given such a wonderful facilities to nearby villages. It gives lots of motivation to other kids.
Ancient city, forgotten in time, a whisper, a fragment of what once stood. We believe our heritage needs to be conserved and protected. What a shame it would be to lose such beauty to time.
This Chandramouleshwar temple is one of the few projects in the country with public and private collaboration. So Hampi Foundation is working with the state archaeology. It's a very encouraging thing that private parties can actually do something with the state archaeology. This monument has a great, very beautiful gopura, and to keep that intact and then strengthen the rest of the structure is a challenge. And I see the walls, the retaining walls, which have been weakened, and actually this conservation project will stabilize the eastern part of the Rishimukh Hill and the banking of it, which can get damaged by the river flow sometimes.
Steps have also been built along the river bank, and we have taken up cleaning and restoring a well of mythological importance.
We must have a magazine to exchange information. We want contemporary art to go all over the world. It is a very unbiased magazine, which is not catering to any gallerists or artists. That is why Art India is unbiased and does not have any kind of SOPs.
The JSW Foundation lays emphasis on infrastructural development in all its townships. The townships are equipped with all facilities ranging from temples to hospitals. The Vidyanagar Township bagged the Prime Minister's Award for Design and Urban Planning. In spite of all we are doing, our efforts are still just a scratch on the surface. We need to penetrate deeper, work harder, and foster an ever-expanding vision. Our forthcoming activities include cherishing dreams, in sharing our success. We believe in not just building industries, but individuals as well. Corporate social responsibility is more than just a word at the Jindal Crew. It's a commitment.
No effort, be it industrial or otherwise, is sustainable unless it takes the needs of society into consideration. We cherish people. Our area of focus are education, livelihood and empowerment, health, sports, conservation and environment.
An innovative and visionary approach to learning. The motive is to get students excited about learning by teaching them through creative, innovative methods and also retain them in schools. We have introduced 71 interactive subject CDs in 3 languages and trained local teachers to improve the quality of education. Parents too are excited as they see hope in education.
Anganwadi provides children with a wholesome meal. We at JSW tried to go a step forward by providing them with low-cost kits and a training in early child education. The basic aim behind this was to empower the children right from their childhood.
The project Village Learning Centers has been set up to teach rural children who, owing to poverty, are deprived of education. So far, 72 students have been mainstreamed. the foundation hospitals conduct regular diagnostic camps at least twice a month.
अभी हमारे ये प्रोजेक्ट जब से शुरू हुआ है मई 2005 से तो लोगों ने बहुत इंटरेस्ट इसमें दिखाया है को उनके हेल्थ एलिमेंट को प्राइमरी स्टेज पे डिटेक्ट करके डायग्नोस करते हैं और अकॉर्डिंगली ट्रीटमेंट देते हैं.
We also focus on nutrition development amidst children by providing wholesome meals and vitamins. In our souls, there is a song to be free, to rise above our circumstances. Who will hear our muffled cries and take us to the realization of our dreams?
मैं यहाँ काम करते हुए एक साल हो गया. मैं तो यहाँ सोची थी नहीं कि यहाँ आऊँगी और ये काम करूँगी बोल के. यहाँ तो बहुत अच्छा लगता है. संगीता मैडम ने है सब लड़कियों के लिए बहुत अच्छा किया.
We have covered around 28 villages and radius of 60 kilometers. Now, currently there are around 300 women who work in 24/7. Our efforts is to change rural India into urban India.
They live in tune with nature. They form 70% of our human capital. We believe the soul of our country needs to be emancipated. The Mahila Dairy Development Group aims at creating livelihood opportunities for rural villagers without removing them from their setting. Fodder production workshops and free veterinary checkups are also conducted. Self-help groups help the women to start entrepreneurial businesses. Vocational training is an important facet of livelihood generation. Here, adolescents are trained in various activities to provide them with skills to make a decent living. Yet another stroke of genius. Who could have thought that women could do that? But right here, in the JSW plant, that's exactly what is happening. The women took it up as a challenge and with training, have proven the mettle within them. Women in our plant stand on equal ground as men.
We build industries. But we respect and conserve nature. Ours is the only zero effluent discharge plant in the world.
Currently, we are running a 4 million ton plant. Generally, 1 ton of steel requires 3,300 liters of water. And we can proudly say that no water goes waste.
This is the place where we receive treated water from all the steel works. This is pumped back to different units in the steel plant for different applications. Thus, by using of water by cascading in different units, we are able to conserve maximum amount of water. We at JSW have spent enormous amount of money in conserving water, be it in terms of water treatment or in case of water wastewater usage. This is how we are making the water consumption least so that all other people who are deprived of water can be benefited.
Jindal Squash Academy has produced nearly about 35 national players and 2 world-class, 7 international squash players. Now this year we have got one boy and one girl who is representing India in 2008 at Switzerland. All the credit goes to JSW who has given such a wonderful facilities to nearby villages. It gives lots of motivation to other kids.
This Chandramouleshwar Temple is one of the few projects in the country with public and private collaboration. So Hampi Foundation is working with the state archaeology. It's a very encouraging thing that private parties can actually do something with the state archaeology. This monument has a great, very beautiful Gopura, and to keep that intact and then strengthen the rest of the structure is a challenge. And I see the walls, the retaining walls, which have been weakened, and actually this conservation project will stabilize the eastern part of the Rishimukh Hill and the banking of it, which can get damaged by the river flow sometimes.
We must have a magazine to exchange information. We want contemporary art to go all over the world. It is a very unbiased magazine, which is not catering to any gallerists or artists. That is why Art India is unbiased and does not have any kind of socks.
The JSW Foundation lays emphasis on infrastructural development in all its townships. The townships are equipped with all facilities ranging from temples to hospitals. The Vidyanagar Township bagged the Prime Minister's Award for Design and Urban Planning. In spite of all we are doing, our efforts are still just a scratch on the surface. We need to penetrate deeper, work harder, and foster an ever-expanding vision. Our forthcoming activities include